All right, we are fast approaching the end of our second day. This is our last session for today, and Yigal is going to tell us all about how to build your own upgrade wizard. Let's give him a round of applause.
Thank you. Yeah, mic is also working fine. Okay, I took a bit of a chance to do some coding today. I prepared something to be sure that we end up with a working upgrade wizard. So I'll end up some copy and pasting stuff, but we'll see the code and a lot of explaining. Few people have seen me yesterday already. I'm a developer at Red Kiwi in the Netherlands. Been in the core team for a few years, and I'm the evil guy who put out the T3 at Minor extension, and also do a lot of the Dutch translations for either core labels and watch new slides. But enough about me. Let's do some magic together. If you have any questions, not about creating your own stuff and solving your own problems and minor code thingies, but the general idea about migration wizards later on, please ask immediately. This topic came to mind because I saw a few colleagues who created backend modules and X-based command controllers to update some data in their projects. I thought, well, why do you do it in that construction? Well, we have a nice install tool with an upgrade wizard, and you can create your own wizard, so why not use the right tool for it? So today we'll have a look at how you can build your own migration wizard. It's actually very simple from the structures. You have only have to do a few things. You have to register it. You have to create a few parts, and yeah, then the hard part is creating the logic itself. But most of the time, you know how to migrate your data, so that should be doable. The registration for an upgrade wizard is really simple. In the global type of free conf vars array, there's an option for the install tool extension. And in the update part, you can register your classes. And then the install tool knows that there is an extra wizard present. This is a large array. You will see the code later. When we start coding, then I'll open the file. But it's just an entry in this array, and that's it. You don't have to call any function or whatever. It's just put your class name in an array, and the install tool knows about it. The parts of an upgrade wizard are really very simple. There are a few abstract classes that come in the core. They are the base of the upgrade wizards. And you can simply extend one of those classes. You have to build some, I call housekeeping functions, or management functions, like what is the name of the wizard, a short description, what does it need, etc. You have to implement a check to see if the update is necessary at all. If it's not necessarily, it won't show it in the list of upgrade wizards that need to be executed. And the last part is, well, the hardest part in coding, perform the actual update. So, that was the part about the slides. Now, just get my transmitter out. This is pretty small, but you recognize the Type 3 version 9 backend, and already started the upgrade part where the upgrade wizard is located. In that part, it's gonna happen all the time. So let's look at some code. I'll blow it up later. can read it. Here are the structures that are hardly readable, but it's really very simple. There's an ex-local-conf file for the registration that I'm going to open, an ex-emconf file, a composer JSON because I wanted to be able to load it with Composer. There is an extension icon and one class file that we're going to make today. So that's it. And to have a look at the registration, I hope it's a bit more readable from the back. This is the largest that PHP Storm allows me to do. That was the large array up there. I added the key migrate redirects because I wanted to create a migration wizard that converts the redirects from real URL and my redirects extension to the ones from the version 9 core. And I made up a class name, and that's just it. And that update array is filled with, if you look in the configuration module, it's filled with all the migration wizards that are registered in the system. They all have their own key and the class name. So there's a use statement, so we can remove that too. Is it large enough that people can read it? Otherwise, please move a bit forward, because the last row must have superhuman eyes. Anyway, I will publish the extension later on, but I need to have some time to upload it to Tel and etc. And then you have an upgrade wizard to upgrade the redirects from real URL to the version 9 sites module or from my redirects. We must make a class. And we call that migrate redirects. And as I said in the slide, it must extend one of the abstract classes from the core. And for this purpose, I selected an abstract download extension update class. There are several of them in the install tool in the core. You can look them up there. It's just a bunch of abstract classes that are there. This one is an update class, that's the last part, and it allows you to download an extension. You've perhaps seen it in the install tool upgrade wizards that you can download ext-compat 6 or some other extension. I don't want to download actually an extension, I just want to make sure that the redirects extension, system extension, is active. Because you can deactivate that one, and we really need it for this one because we want to migrate the redirects. So that one must be present. Class. And my editor allows me to create the functions that we need from the abstract class. That's really helpful. Skip the first one, and we go to the second function. It wants to have an identifier. We just return a nice identifier like migrate redirects. It's nothing fancy. It's just to keep all the upgrade wizards apart, and he uses that for some housekeeping internally. Just some name. And it's set in the comment, should be the same string as used in the ex-local-conf registration, and I use the same name. um, If it said this should be the same string, then I think you should use the same string. It's not a must, but I don't know who wrote that line. I think it should have read this must be the same string. Yeah, you can test it. Change the string and see if it's still working, and if it doesn't, then you know that was a must. And you have to figure out things for yourself too. It's just to show you some direction, like you can do something with upgrade wizards in the install tool. This one I'm going to copy from elsewhere because I made a nice title, the get title function. It's the title that is shown with every upgrade wizard, and there's a description below, and I'll copy that one too because I'm really lazy and I've done the work earlier, so why not repeat it? I had a nice title, Migrate Redirects from Real URL and XMI Redirects to Core Redirects. Now, pretty descriptive. Everybody knows what it should do. Description can be a bit longer, so I thought, well, publish my next novel. Four lines. Wow. A bit of a background story that there were redirects in those modules and extensions, and that they're now supported, and what is needed. Well, I figured out we must have a domain record because the redirects in either Real URL or My Redirects were connected to domain records, so we must have a sysdomain table, and we either have one of the tables from My Redirects or from Real URL. And if those are present, then we can migrate them. And we're going to implement that also in the checks later on. Then we came to the confirmation. For upgrade wizards that allow you to install an extension, then you can get the question if you want to download and install it and have to show yes or no. So we have to build it here. And for this, we also need to create some data, like what kind of extension do we expect. So we go back to one I prepared earlier. One is the, oops. Back to the get confirmation. I make up I'll return the confirmation, and that is also an object, so I'll create that one. Yeah, it has already red lines below it. More typos! Yeah! I'm so happy with PHP Storm, actually. It showed me so many typos I make. white screens anymore. The confirmation part, let me see what was about. That was a confirmation thingy. Confirmation, yeah. And that is a confirmation from the install tool, blah, 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 confirmation object. And now this works, and I have to initiate that. So we're going to add a nice constructor. And I have to pass it some data. If I remember well, yeah. The constructor says this confirmation is a new type of 3 CMS install updates confirmation. was. And it has some parameters, the title. Well, it's a confirmation, so I'll say, are you sure? Yes, later on. I want to display a message. Oh, sorry, that's one I pasted before. You should install the redirects extension only if needed, plus the description of that extension. I copied a lot from existing upgrade wizards, you've noticed probably. And the third one is the default value. Well, I want it to be true. And then a confirmation string. Yeah, that's one I left out. That's yes, execute, no, do not execute. No, that's kind of default stuff. That's fine. Now we have a missing thing like the description. PHP Storm isn't complaining about extension because that already exists in the abstract class. That's very nice of them. It's an extension model, so we have to add that too. This is too much typing for me. So in the constructor, well, we can see it now. I must include class, it's an extension model, yeah. I want to include the extension redirects. And I think instead of a nice title, redirects, and the version string, well, I'm in a version 9 installation, so it's 9.5 for all system extensions. The composer name, that's something you can look up. It's called type3/CMS redirects. That's all available in the composer stuff of the core. And I made a nice description. I probably copied that also from the redirects system extension. And now we created a new extension model, and that's something that the abstract class and the rest of the install tool can work with. They have code and logic to install extensions. And like I said, this one won't be downloaded, but it's just to make sure that it's active. Well, the cat description is also present. Yes, it has a description, so it can display it. We're almost done with housekeeping. Is an update necessary? Well, we start on because we're just going to try and see if we can get something in the install tool. We just say, yes, true, it's always necessary. Please don't do that in real life, because then you never, you know, always looks like that it's actually necessary. And you can most of the time do beautiful checks, just see if there is a table present and if it's has any records in it, and then you have a really useful check. But this is just for the first part, we'll replace it later. The prerequisite, that's another nice feature in the install tool. It can express some requirements, like the database must be up to date. Well, in this case, I'm going to work with the database, so I really liked that it's up to date. So I went to one of the other install tools that are present in the core and thought, well, what can we steal from that one? Not the update necessary, but the prerequisites. Oh, that is just an array that we have to use. Yeah, you have to steal a lot of code that already exists, because why should you invent it if someone else built it and you can just copy and paste it? There are a bunch of classes there that represent all those requirements. Yeah, importer.
Those are not upgrades.
Yeah.
Check class.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you put them in these functions, then the install tool will make sure that it checks if the database was up to date. And it doesn't run anything before it knows that it's up to date. In version 9 and later, it does a lot of silent updates already to make sure that it's workable, like updating your database with extra tables and extra fields, because that's something you can do safely. And then you know that the right tables are present and the right fields are there. It has a nice line through it, because it's marked as internal. Because, yeah, well, now we're doing something a bit close to the core, so we can use all kinds of internal stuff. That's a question. And you want to automate that too. Yeah, the question was if that this is the place to have more requirements like upgrade wizard that and that was run. These are a few requirements that are programmed in the install tool itself. And well, it is a class that does a lot of things, so we can jump there and see if there are more classes available. Then I'll go to the small view and switch there. In this directory, we can search for this class implements a prerequisite interface and a chatty interface. And it's called indeed prerequisites. There are not many, I don't think there is one that says I have to run this wizard first. But you can implement that yourself, of course. Well, you can write something in the system registry if one wizard has run, and then you can read that that piece of data and check if it has run. I think that's more a thing that you can do with the confirmation and all those messages that you put something there, like do you want to run it? I see that one hasn't run. Please run it first. Back to our nice class. Okay, we've said that it has to have a database update. And, well, nothing that it says that we should create now. So let's see if the upgrade wizard something. Still loading. Yeah, I'm using a local DDEV installation, so don't think it's a really slow type of 3 installation. It's just my local machine. It's a bit small, but I'll try to explain. The bar says that it's at 90%, and the title that we created, migrate redirects from XURL and XMI redirects to the core redirects, is there, and the nice 4-line description that we made, plus the execute button. We can check if the rest was working, not completely executed, but we know that we wanted to have confirmation, and yes, it shows you should install the redirects extension only if needed, and then the description manage redirects for your type of 3 based website. So everything, the housekeeping functions we made are there, and we just have to check yes and perform the updates, which we are not going to do now. We're now gonna make some logic in it. Let's go down. Update necessary. Well, we figured out that we need to check something actually, and not say that everything was necessary all the time. This is a pretty weird construction, because I use it in more than one occasion and it's just there in my template. Most of the times the checks are a bit more complicated and involve calling a few functions. And in this case there's only one that was not created yet, so it can be a one-liner. Yes, I know. Sorry, I was a bit thirsty. Yeah, no, it's not it's not deprecated. It's marked as internal because it's internal to the install tool. And you should not use it. But I'm creating something that belongs in the install tool, an extra upgrade wizard. So I'm happy with using all kinds of internal stuff. Yeah. If you look in the imported classes at the top, they see that we also have the internal extension model. That's also marked as internal. In this case, we're so close that, yeah, use it. Be careful, it might not work for version 10 or 11 or anything that's the next version. But anyway, then by then you probably need to recreate your migration wizards anyway, if you still have to migrate those data. And in the case of the redirects, those are the same in version 10, so it's not necessary anymore. But you'll see more of those lines appearing. I thought you were pointing at the fact that that function didn't exist yet. Well, we're going to check a few things, like there is a database table and if the either of those real URL or my directs table exists and if it contains records. I think you can believe that that works. You'll have to import some stuff. Oh, that works fine. Okay, I made a few other functions to keep every function really small, that it was either readable on the screen, but also understandable. And perhaps if we're one day going to add unit tests to it, that it can be testable because it's very small. So I need to create the two check functions. Oh, that's only one. Okay, that's why I made an extra function, because I'm going to check tables. Well, in the first one, we're first going to check if function for if table is present and not empty. Which table? Sys domain. I want domain records available. And we need those not for the sites module per se, but we need them because the data that we're going to migrate depends on the domain records. And so we must retrieve the right domain from them. I made a function that checks if the table was present and also does a query account on a field. So I have to give him a field name like domain name. That's one of the fields in the system main table. And I'm going to have to check the database tables that we're going to use for the final migration. And for each table, I must check if it's present and not empty. And if either one is found, the first one that is found is already nice, then we can return a true. And we know that the wizard is required. The function for the import here, yeah. Just make a connection pool class instance, and we're going to use get connection by name and use the name default because we don't really know what else other connections are there. We are in the install tool, so we cannot rely on too many things. But we are sure that there was at this point there is a default connection available. Then we're gonna ask him the schema manager and list all the table columns for the table we're gonna check, and see if the table, the field that we want to check, if it's there. And then we're going to make a simple query account on that table and see if there are any entries. Well, why is there a semicolon? Shouldn't be there. In the previous one, we see that we need the tables. I created a simple array for myself with various tables names. Somewhere here near the top. Okay, my table names, the long one for the my redirect extension. And I say, well, the field, the column URL must be there at any time. And for the real URL redirects table, there's also a field URL. And if those are present and the tables are not empty, or either one of them is not empty, then I'm happy and we can continue. If we now go to the bottom, you'll see that the table names is also happy here, so we can do a check. In my local installation, I already made sure that there is a this domain table, and there's one record in it. We can make it a bit larger. Well, there's... Hi, Siri. Sorry. There is actually a domain record there with my local DDEV domain. So that one is happy. And I downloaded from one client installation a wire redirects thingy. And that is filled with all kinds of redirects. 62 records. Well, nice. Plenty of data in there. These are the UIDs of the pages, and this demo installation is almost empty. So one thing that won't be working in the end is that the actual redirect is working, because I didn't bother copying this installation with, wow, well, you see, over 72,000 pages in it. Yeah, that was a bit too much. So... Well, at least the upgrade wizard should still be working, because we implemented a nice check. Loading upgrade wizards. Yeah, 98%, and it's still there. Okay, so far, so good. My check is working. Hooray. Back to the code. We have checked that it is working, and then what is there? Oh, an unhandled exception. Fine. And now you think, where should I put my logic? Well, that's not in the abstract class, because it really couldn't care less if there is an executed function or not. And okay, there is an execute update on the prepared earlier. This one doesn't seem to do a lot, but it does two important things. It installs the extension, the one, the redirect that we did, and that is a function that is already present in the abstract class, and that's why we did the extension download class we in the beginning. Because you want to be able to install an extension, and if it's not installed, if it's already installed, it doesn't complain. It just makes sure that it's there. And if the installation is successful, we'll run the database redirects. And those are really not that exciting for this demonstration, because that is the business logic that you actually want to make yourself. So I'm gonna copy a whole lot of things. And again, I wasn't completely original, because there was already in my redirects an upgrade possibility, and that one was really helpful because I copied a lot of those functions. Let's see, I have to import a few classes here and there. That one doesn't. Hash I have to implement. Yeah, I was looking through a lot of redirect upgrades, and they were using just a couple of domains. And yeah, you can use a query for looking up each domain record, but it's still the same anyway. So I thought, well, just use an array and implement a really simple local cache. And or just import these few classes we need here. Like I said, many of this code is already borrowed. We have the, okay, a little nice cache. I have a nice comment. There, okay, then it should be a really happy function. And let's see if it runs. Let's start a full tool again, and I'm sure that all the classes are there. In these cases, you're also happy with responsive backends, that the styling is now also usable on small devices. Okay. Let's run and hope that it doesn't put out any errors. Phew, update successful. No, we're not there. We have to make sure that this is there. There's the redirects module in the site management. And see, there are a lot of redirects all through this domain, and we can even open them. Two pages with it, and that must be 62 ones. So all the records from my redirects are now migrated to Sites module. Okay, you know, most of your questions were already asked, but if you have any, there's still 6 minutes.
Questions?
Hi. The method name for your logic, was that a fixed name, so it knew what to write?
The execute function is a fixed name, yes, but the rest, what I copied, that was just stuff I made up, just cut it in some pieces that my mind could process it while making it. And it's just the business logic, so it wasn't really interesting for this demonstration.
Ask something else? Can I ask something else?
Yeah, okay. You still have the mic, so.
Yeah, it's true. Do you have any other use cases that you can think of for an upgrade wizard?
Yeah, there's all kinds of data migration that you can do. One recent project, we had to merge two sites, and there was a lot of custom records in it, so import-export was a bit out of the question. So we, combined those databases, and there were a lot of plugins on pages with in FlexForms fields that pointed to a folder where it should fetch the records. So I really dug into the FlexForm handling and made an upgrade wizard that actually migrated all the data, parsed all the FlexForms and changed all it and wrote everything back into the database. And then when we were finished with all the preparations, the day came that we had to make the last upgrade from the recent data from the site, and it was just following all the upgrade wizards, and one of my integrator colleagues did the upgrade. He just pressed every migration until he came to my migration button and pressed it, and it was a few seconds and it was done. So those are the use cases. If you have data to migrate between installations, but not only in upgrades, but also in other cases, you can use them. Yeah, way, way back.
Question.
Run.
About the information, what upgrade wizards have already been executed, is this handled automatically by the install tool, or do I have to manage it for myself?
The install tool keeps track of which upgrade wizards are executed. If you look at the install tool in the upgrade wizards list, then you see a lot of them at the bottom. Those are marked as done already. That is automatically done, and you can also unmark a few as not executed. And in the rest of the cases, then you have to dig into the registry table, sys registry, and there is a list of the upgrade wizards that are already executed.
Anyone else? No?
Well, we're going to see a lot of migration wizards tonight.
All right, so that was it. That was the last session for our second day, and thankfully my last shift as a host. I'll see you all at dinner at 6, I hope, and then let's get together and write some code tonight. Have a good one.